Interested in creating professional quality screen recordings for presentations, demos, or tutorials? In this video, I'll take you behind the scenes to show you exactly how I create my Notion and digital tool tutorials for YouTube. My go-to tool for this is Screen Studio, which is a Mac app that has completely transformed my workflow. Before, I had choppy mouse movements, I added manual zooms, and it took me more time to make my videos with a lower quality, as you can see with this example. Now I can add smooth mouse movements, automatic zoom effects, saving me a lot of time, and I'm also much happier with the end result. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's dive right in! So to get started with Screen Studio, all you have to do is go to screen.studio and then you can go to download this app. With Screen Studio, it's only for Macs. It's really designed to be used in a Mac setting, and even the background choices, as you'll see later, are modeled after Mac. So it really has this Mac look when you use Screen Studio. I wanted to show you is how Screen Studio works once you download it. And for this, it's kind of funny, but I had to record it directly from my Mac as a screen recording because I cannot really show this bar otherwise. So this is going to be one of the only times I don't use Screen Studio. But when you have this, you can see that you can go to the settings here, and there are all kinds of settings with Screen Studio. So you can hide desktop icons in the recorded video. You can hide the Screen Studio dock icon while recording. Highlight recorded area during the recording. And then there's also open quick share widget after recording. And then there's also speaker notes. I like the speaker notes feature because it actually lets you have these notes while you're recording the screen at the same time, so you can remember your script. Then there's also recording countdown if you want to add that. And there's also some more advanced features like use modern recording engine if available. And then finally, there's more further settings. If you go to the settings, you'll see a lot more options. Start Screen Studio at login, hide dock icon, usage data. Then there's also recording settings, editing settings, quick export, shortcuts, experimental, and then some more advanced features here. So one of the things I also like about Screen Studio is that it's not that overwhelming to use. There's just enough features that it feels really easy to use. The next thing you can do is to add the system audio. So if you want to record system audio from all apps and so on, you can add that here. Here you can see that I'm using my Shure MV7 microphone. So you can see that being used as I speak. Then you can also set up the camera if you'd like, and you can even use your iPhone camera. You can change the camera resolution and so on. And then another thing I really like, that if I'm trying to film a tutorial that's on my iPhone, I can also add device if I have it connected via USB. And then you can also do area. So if you have a specific area that you want to record, for example, if you're recording a short, then this can be really useful since you can really change the size. And they have all of these settings here. So it just streamlines the whole process on how big your screen recording should even be. And then there's also the whole window, and then you can just do display. So if I'm recording a Notion tutorial, I would probably just click the window and then I can just start recording immediately for my Notion tutorials. So now I'm going to go ahead and show you what it's like to record with Screen Studio. So this is going to be the behind the scenes of what it looks like for me as I use Screen Studio. So I'm going to go ahead and click window, and then I'm going to hover on the window that I want to record, which in this case is this Notion page. So I'm going to click start recording. This arrow allows me to choose after recording what happens, as well as some other things. And I'm just going to click start recording. So once I start recording, it starts showing how many seconds that this video has been being recorded. I can also click here if I want to restart and I'm not happy with things. I can also just throw it to the trash, or I can just pause the recording. So this is kind of what it looks like for me when I film a Notion or digital tool tutorial. I might add something like a page title, and usually I go to the top right hand corner, three dots, turn on small text full width, and then I might go and add an icon here. And let's say I choose something like this, add cover, change cover, and then I have unsplash or gallery. And then I can start typing here. And I also wanted to show what happens when I use a keyboard shortcut. So let's say that I type slash, and then I have a heading 3, and I have sample text. Then if I want to duplicate this sample text, I can do Command or Control D, and then it's going to show up like this. So now I've done a few things here, which is adding page titles, adding cover photos, all of these things. So I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording. So now it's actually showing me a preview of what I've just recorded. If I want to go ahead and already start editing this, I can click edit here. Otherwise, I can also already share this immediately. I can copy it. I can also save to file. So I'm going to go ahead and just click edit so I can start the editing process. The first thing that I usually do when I start editing my screen studio recording is that I want to add the wallpaper that makes sense for me. So let's say that I'm in macOS, I just want something like this. And then you can also change the background blur. So if you want it off, you can do this. If you want it more, you can turn it higher. Then there's also padding. So I usually like to keep it a little bit bigger so it's easier to see the screen. And then you can also adjust the roundedness of the corners, and you can also change the inset as well depending on what you like. You can also increase or decrease the shadow as needed, and there's also advanced shadow settings, so you can really have this three-dimensional look with Screen Studio. Another thing that's great with Screen Studio is that you can also save things as a preset so that you can always have the same one if you'd like to keep it all the same. There's also gradient options and then color, and then there's also image. So if you want to add a custom image in the background, that's also totally possible. The next thing that you can adjust is the cursor size. So if I'm here, you can see the cursor, but I can actually make it huge or I can make it smaller. And then there's also different options on what the cursor looks like. So you can have this round thing, or you can do different kinds of arrows. There's really a lot of options. I tend to stick with just the default cursor, but just a little bit bigger. There's also always use pointer cursor even if selecting text. So if you don't like that, for example, your cursor changes shapes as you go, then you can turn that on. Otherwise, you can turn it off. So then you might have a different style, like when you highlight things. Then there's also hide cursor if not moving. I like to keep this on so that it doesn't get distracting. And then you can even set how many seconds that you want that to do. And then loop cursor position, click effects. Then there's click sounds if you want to add that. And even rotations like this. So there's a lot to do here. I tend to keep things very simple and minimal, so I choose the basic cursor style and a bit bigger so it's easier to see. Then we have captions. If you want to use an AI model to generate the transcript, you can also do that. And you can also auto language. So I can even do generate transcript now like this, and it's going to start generating. And while this is generating, I'm going to go over some of the other settings. So here we have the microphone. So you can mute the microphone, improve microphone audio. You can even add background audio. And then there's also keyboard shortcuts. So this is what I wanted to show. So if I turn this on, I can enable shortcuts. And then what happens is that when I do a keyboard shortcut, which was here, it's going to actually show that shortcut. So you can see here that I press Command D. And you can also change the label size. So if you're actually doing some kind of complex tutorial that requires a lot of keyboard shortcuts, this can be really helpful for someone watching it. Then there's also animation. So if you want the screen animation style to be focused or smooth, and then there's also cursor animation styles that you can adjust, and then motion blur, and then advanced motion blur settings. Then we have this timeline, and if you want to add a zoom, it's super easy. You can just go like this and then it automatically zooms. And now you can also see the transcript that's been added with the AI. So that's also really useful if you want to add that in. Then you can also adjust the zoom levels here as well by moving this slider. And the way that the zoom works is that it auto adds the zoom. So most of the time I don't even need to actually manually add in the zooms, but if I do need to add it in, it's so much easier than if I'm using another video editing tool with this smooth zoom that's always consistent. The next thing you can do is you can also split the clip really easily. You can enable audio scrubber. You can also preview size, and you can also timeline zoom depending on what you want to see. There's also this mask mode, which I also really like. So if there's some things that you want to hide on the screen recording, which sometimes happens, especially if you're using your own computer, then I can also use it for sensitive data. And then let's say I want to hide this add icon, I can just layer that over. And then if I play it, then it's going to actually smooth that out for me so that it's blurred out. And I can also choose whether that's sensitive data or highlighting that specific moment. The next things I wanted to show is the output. So you can do wide, square, classic, vertical, tall, portrait. So this is helpful depending on the platform that you want to export into. And then we have crop like this. So those are the main settings for this screen studio. As you can see, it's just so smooth, and then you can really adjust it to your own needs, and it just makes everything look more consistent, which is something that I really like about it. When you're ready to export your screen studio recording, you can click this export button here. And then what you can do is either export to a file, to your clipboard, or as a shareable link. The shareable link is really useful because you can change the video title easily. You can also set it to private so that only the people you share this video with will be able to watch it. So this is useful for sharing it among your team or with your clients, for example. And all you would need to do is to export and share with one click. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in Screen Studio, who's the sponsor of today's video, be sure to check the link in the description below. I've been an avid Screen Studio user for around a year now, so any video you currently watch from my channel has been created using that tool. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to let me know, and I hope to see you all in the next video.